السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين على أمور الدنيا والدين وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. Brothers and sisters, we welcome you to this meeting, and we praise to Allah with His grace that we are all here today from people who have come from very, very far, from the US, from UK. We are glad that you have arrived safely, and we welcome you again to this meeting. Thank you very much for being present and make your time. We know that it's not easy for people who are very busy with their own things that you are doing back home, but this meeting has been drafted and crafted to begin a very serious effort of the Ummah unity struggle. We will begin now our meeting with the recitation of the Quran. I invite Brother Ustaz Jamaluddin Ahmad to read the Quran. Tafadhal.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن تطيعوا فريقا من الذين أوتوا الكتاب يردوكم بعد إيمانكم كافرين. وكيف تكفرون وأنتم تتلى عليكم آيات الله وفيكم رسوله، ومن يعتصم بالله فقد هدي إلى صراط مستقيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا، واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ كنتم أعداء فألف بين قلوبكم فأصبحتم بنعمته إخوانا، وكنتم على شفا حفرة من النار فأنقذكم منها، كذلك يبين الله لكم آياته لعلكم تهتدون. ولتكن منكم أمة يدعون إلى الخير ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر، وأولئك هم المفلحون. ولا تكونوا كالذين تفرقوا واختلفوا من بعد ما جاءهم البينات، وأولئك لهم عذاب عظيم. صدق الله العظيم.
Thank you, brother Ustaz Jamaluddin. The essential ayat that was read by Brother Jamaluddin is the one that it became the theme of our meeting. Yani wa'tasimu bihablillahi jami'a wa la tafarraqu. Brothers and sisters, this is indeed a special occasion that we have come here with the niyat, with the intention that we want to be the servant of Allah in the best way that we can, and with all the difficulties that we are facing right now, we know that that would not be an excuse for us to keep on our work to become the best among the whole of mankind. Khaira ummah ukhrijat linnas. Therefore, this meeting is really, in substance, a very serious meeting, but we have discussed among the committee, steering committee, that it will be also a very relaxed meeting in the sense that we will not be having a seminar type of discussion. It is more a free and open discussion between us, so that we can actually exchange views and suggestions among us to deal with the problems that we are facing now. So amongst us, we have invited from various organizations and individuals, intellectuals and scholars, and definitely we know that we are much more serious in looking at the task of making this ummah unity realization, and it has to become the most important effort between us. So the discussion that will kick off right from this morning until tomorrow, inshallah, will be held in a very free way, and we can exchange views in a very healthy and brotherly way. So inshallah, I will then hand over this session, first session. By first, we will hear words and wisdoms from the chairperson of the organization that is that has organized this program, that is the Universal Justice Network. The introduction of UJN will be done by Brother Haji Muhyiddin Qadir afterwards. But I will just add a little bit on that, that the UJN, we were able to organize it here with the help of two local organizations. One is Shura. Shura is the Assembly of Muslim Scholars of Asia. The chairperson is Ustaz Abu Ghani Shamsuddin, which he will introduce afterwards. And also an umbrella Muslim council, consultation council of Muslim NGOs in Malaysia, that is MAPIM. The director, executive director, Ustaz Zulkifli Ibrahim is here. So we try to help together with the secretariat of the Penang-based UJN, that is Citizens International. So that will be a little bit of the introduction I want to give you. The whole essence of this meeting, why we want to have it, what intention, what purpose, what result we want from this meeting, will be deliberated by Brother Haji Muhyiddin. But you have already got your materials, the kits are with you. We may add a little more as we go on further. Some other papers will be circled around, so please bear with us. We have not been able to get the materials as soon as possible. So now let us, before we have our ta'aruf, we will have our introduction and welcoming and opening remarks by the chairperson of Universal Justice Network, Haji S.M. Muhammad Idris, who is the person who has been pushing this idea of this discussion on ummah unity and the work that we should be doing. So I give the floor to John Haji S.M. Muhammad Idris.
quite uplifting period of time. This great times. You are all coming here gives me an uplifting feeling that all of you jointly come here to do a greater things in life. That's what sometimes Azmi was complaining just now, that it is very hard to get Muslims to move faster because you hear here too they come late in for meetings. I said, don't worry, we put fire in everybody. So the question is, then generally is very uplifting to see, because that our concern for our unity, that brings all of us from different parts of the world. Otherwise, you won't be traveling here to come here to spend time. But whatever we aspire, but it's meant to be followed with serious action. That's why I have a great admiration for the groups like Hezbollah, who has really gave a great strength to Muslims through the action, and able to take on great shaitan, backed by another shaitan. So they're able to, which all the many Muslim states can't do, they're able to do. Which gives me a greater feeling. And again, as I told you, we live in greater times. You see, I was thinking very uplifting as well as a very great times. That means we see many things are happening which are to our liking. Slowly we see one time the great, nation of Turkey, which used to be Muslims look upon as a Khalifa those days, suddenly went down. And they were the great agents of secularism who are controlling the military, the judiciary, of course the society as a whole in many ways. Now slowly it's wearing off. So it gives me a great feeling. That is last 2-3 years, in fact I don't know the actual time, when this new party took over power from Turkey. Then we see the last year, the great frown fell in Egypt. So it's all very great times. The frown there, in another small frown in Tunisia. Now they are struggling with all these fellows in Yemen, in Bahrain. Of course the great shaitan still exists in Riyadh. So this is the problem we are facing. So these great times also give a greater feeling. But at the same time, we have to articulate, to identify problems will give a greater speed to do our work. So within this, many small things holds back us from a great march towards a great destiny. So Mujahideen, as I mentioned to you, this word, I was thinking, the separations among Muslims, they exist of course, but it should not become an obstacle. It may be for greater good, I suppose. So the problem I was thinking, like particularly these two sects of Muslims who are the major people here, I was going to give some suggestions in the sense, one, that how are the joint activities can be done among Shia Sunnis, both groups? Can they, like Ustad Ghani and another Shia Alim, can write a book on Muslim unity? Can they send scholars to Muslim scholars, Shia scholars go to Sunni schools, Sunni scholars go to Shia schools? They can pray together, they can work together. So some element of working together must be articulated. So that the difference goes off. I don't know whether there's possibilities, I do not know. Another thing, Jaideen, I'm very concerned. If you look at the whole human development report, it's done by many Arab scholars, without so much of wealth around, their position is not very good. They are power poor, they are illiterate, they are in the backward and everything. So, similarly, you see Muslims all over the world in a very difficult position. Like in the case of minority areas, even a Muslim. I used to even wonder that the great giant, sleeping giant, Indonesia, cannot be woken up. If it wakes up, it will be a great impetus to this part of the world. The giant has to be woken up. You see, they used to say, like about China, they say sleeping giant. Now it has become really a giant against Americans. Not American, but at least within the context. Similarly, Indonesia can play a greater role if it wakes up. So he's still struggling. Hopefully, inshallah, they'll get all the spirit and so on. Similarly, look at Bangladesh, is in a miserable position. India, the big population, they got 150 million or 200 million, I don't know, Muslims, one of the biggest Muslim population. I think their country is not very good. So we all have a greater responsibility to see, to eradicate the poverty, to eradicate illiteracy. And again, you see the amount of no directions among the youths here. I mean, here, can you formulate certain idea to fight all that sort of negative factors? Drug taking, smoking, what not? There are so many, I mean, here. I don't want to even mention that amount of abortion, amount of child being thrown in dustbins, amount of prostitutions all over the world. All these are a shame for us. So the question is that Muslims must take really a plan. One, to create unity among themselves, what are the impediments, then remove the impediments. And again, to fight against all the other negative factors, which we have a responsibility to be answerable to Allah. Those who really feel. And moreover, all the seminars, meetings will become useless unless we go on in action. Action is the real essence of life. We have to have action. That's why, Mujahideen, it is giving me a great pleasure welcoming you just to say a few words. But I would look forward to a great, you all going to have good discussions. But from there must flow the ideas and action. Idea and action. This is the emphasis of my urge to you, so that inshallah you all can have a very successful meeting. From that, we can carry on. And I'm very, very, happy to welcome you on the Universal Justice Network. And of course, my colleague, Mr. Mushahid, Masood, will be also saying a word because we are joined. Masood will take over from you. So I hope. The jihad has come a long way, and now he's go further. Slowly, frowns were dying, and other Namruds will go. Similarly, all will go. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajeem. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. There isn't really much for me to say. Everything has been said, needs to be said, has been said. If I may just sort of re-emphasize that we have seen many victories in the last few years. The victory of Islamic Party in Turkey against a secular state, which was one of the most powerful states of the region. Prior to that, we saw the removal of Shah from Iran. Yes. And indeed, we have seen the victory of Hezbollah, we have seen the victory of Hamas, and we have seen the victory of our brothers in Egypt, and a few of us went together as a delegation from UJN, and the brothers are here. We were extremely impressed by the dedication of our brothers, and indeed we are seeing other victories. But having said that, the shaitan is not lying down. It's active. In some ways it's more active than we Muslims are. It's more organized than we are, and unfortunately is more united than we are. And this brings us to the reason that we are here. We feel that part of the work of the shaitan is to divide our ummah, because by dividing our ummah, they will actually achieve their purpose. They will weaken us. And unfortunately, I have to say that we have got agents among us, and we have got dedicated, sincere people who have been misguided, that actually end up working for the cause of disunity rather than the cause of unity. And it's a distraction, it's a fitna, and it's we feel very strongly that something needs to be done. We have gathered here to actually look at it and find solutions. And not just in one part of the world, but much wider. Because we feel that we should not allow the conflict between haq and batil, which will continue on the day of Qiyamah. We should actually strengthen the haq and the truth. And part of that is to create that concept of unity, which should be there. And the sense of purpose, that our purpose on this life is the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to stand on the side of Haqq, not doing distraction into other things. And unfortunately, that has happened, and this is hence we are here. Inshallah, in the next few days, in the next 2 days, we will be able to sort of tackle this and come up with some solutions, some practical ways forward. It's not going to be a talk show. You're not going to get people giving speeches here, you know, and then normal conferences. This is a round table discussion. This is your gathering. It's for you to discuss, to come up with solution, to actually find and move forward. I will not say anything more than that, except praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that will put the barakah that is needed. So inshallah, by end of tomorrow, we have actually begun to be more active in creating the unity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded of us. And jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.